Hey, what is up, everybody? This is Stephen Breach coming to you here for Stock Talk, September 2nd. Today is Wednesday. Really nice day. Honestly, Monday we were down a little bit. Tuesday, really strong day. Followed it up with a really strong Wednesday as well. Today we were up 2%, profited about 200 bucks. We had some ups, we had some downs. But I have been telling you guys for the last 2 days that I really thought DraftKings and Penn were the surefire bets. This morning, DraftKings announced that Michael Jordan came on as an investor as well as an advisor for the company. I don't really know what Michael Jordan does to try and bring in more, I guess, fans, customers, whatever you want to say it, for a company like DraftKings. I don't really see Michael Jordan as being a real big go-getter. Maybe they're just going to use him like in ads or something like that. We all saw what Michael Jordan was able to do for the NBA video game a couple of years ago. But this morning before the bell, DraftKings up 12%, fell all the way down to just over 1% being up, and then rallied before the bell to end up being up 8%. I honestly believe that there's still room to grow on DraftKings. It's still something that you could put money into. It might not go up, you know, all of a sudden. But if a company like Penn was sort of guessed to go up to about $200 when it's really only sitting at about 58, I believe, as of right now, DraftKings sure has room to grow. You know, they're gonna have the sports gambling, which is only gonna get bigger as it opens up in more states online. You've got their fantasy that they've been built on, and then they just have like online poker, horse racing, everything like that that you want to do, casino games like that, and spend money on. They're gonna take it if you want to give it to them. So DraftKings up 8%. I really believe that this still has room to grow. I was telling people last week when the NBA as well as Major League Baseball shut down for those 2 days, DraftKings took a hit. And I said, use that like you're using a coupon and cash that sucker in and make some money. And hopefully you guys listened and you guys jumped on that. As well as that, MGM was up 4%. Caesars was up 3.86%. So your gambling stocks did well. I did see that Penn was down today, but it was down, wasn't it down like less than a half of a percent? It was down 0.69%, down 40 cents. That's a bounce back right there. There's no way in the world that Penn's going down. We've all seen what it's been doing as of late. It's been ripping and tearing, and I think it's going to keep going forward. From there, we had the restaurants have a boom today. Red Robin was up 6%. Dave & Buster's up 4%. I saw a play. Where the heck did play go? Dave & Buster's up 4%. So Cheesecake Factory up 1.75%. Bloomin' Onion had a real strong day yesterday. That was up at 1.33% as well. That one still got room to grow. Bloomin' Onion, Outback Steakhouse, up 42% since Kevin O'Kevin first told me to put money in there. So that one's really going. Cheesecake is something that people laugh at me. Cheesecake up 54% since putting money in that back in March. From there, we're going to look at Mark up 3.5. We had Southwest up 3.33. NSPR was up 2, and it's almost up 3, I guess you could say. RTX up 2.25. JetBlue up 2%. WB was up just under 2%. We had Boeing up 1.5, Disney up 1.33, Carnival Cruise Lines up 1.25, Nokia was up 1, Pfizer up just over 3/4, Norwegian Cruise Lines up 1/3, Spirit was up 0.5, IDEX was even. I don't know any stock that's even more often than IDEX is. Cody Makeup Brands down almost 2%, Top Ships down 2.33. We've got CLSN down 2.5. Fastly down 3.33. And Luckin Coffee down 7%. Basically almost giving back everything we had in those 2 big days, Friday and Monday. So we'll see what goes down. Really, really strong days out of that. So, man. Good stuff. As of right now, we're up 29%, up $2,300, tacking on another $200 after yesterday. So We'll see. It's going really, really good right now. We'll have to see if we have another good day on Thursday. So peace out, everybody. And I'll see you guys tomorrow morning in the video.